Zup, y'all, it's John Masterly.
And Lou.
He was pretty much convinced that he was providing instructions for alien visitors from Venus. And you still wouldn't want to check this place out?
No.
Behold, the Integatron. I'm trying to come up with my most epic voice. The Integatron. So what is this mysterious massive dome structure? Well, when we found out, it was even crazier than my initial thought.
We were driving through the Mohave Desert in California. When we got to a spot near Joshua Tree, that's when we spied this curious sight.
My instant reaction seeing the Integatron, I'll bet it's some UFO nut who wanted to look for signs of aliens. And you know what? I wasn't far from the truth.
Ooh, Lynette, we totally gotta go to this place. Integatron!
What?
I know, it sounds like a new villain, Transformers. I am Integatron.
Hell no.
No, you gotta check it out, right? This building, this giant dome, built out of middle of nowhere, pretty much close to where we're staying in this Airstream park, and built by best described as a nut job, was convinced this dome he built was capable of rejuvenation, anti-gravity, and most important of all, and most impressive of all, time travel. You want to look younger, right? This is the way to do it. Rejuvenation and time travel. Anti-gravities, that means your boobs will stop sagging too. They'll go upwards. They'll get that perky kind.
Babe, nothing is sagging on my chest.
Oh, that's
okay?
True. There's nothing to sag yet. Come on, let's check this out.
No.
This place was designed by George Van Tassel. He actually believed this place could heal the body.
This thing was built in the 50s, which was a good decade before drugs became popular in American culture. So you know this guy's mind was already high on something else.
Oh yeah. He had to get the money to build it from somewhere. And a good chunk of that money came from Howard Hughes. That's right, the famous aviator. The one portrayed by Leonardo DiCaprio. And yes, the same person who also at one point in his life had a mental illness and would spend vast amounts of his fortune in really questionable projects. That was a long time ago. Today, the place has evolved into a tourist destination for the spiritually awakened. It's hyped for its acoustically perfect structure, and people come from all over the world for sound baths, which is kind of like a meditation session with tones and sounds from these quartz bowls where the sound would ricochet off the dome.
All right, so this place, I love the Wikipedia. I had to look this place up. Designed by UFOologists, which I don't know if it's a real thing because I'm not willing to click 40 links deep into Wikipedia to validate it, but he was pretty much convinced that he was providing instructions for alien visitors from Venus.
Oh my gosh.
And you still wouldn't want to check this place out?
No, baby, have you seen any Asian in there?
That's the point. Our whole vlog is about Asian American exploring the world.
Exploring.
That's right. We'll be like the first Asian Americans in this place.
Nope.
Hey, as silly as this sounds, at least it's better than what the alternative was. Some people wanted to turn this place into a disco. So there you go. If you're ever out in this neck of the desert, this place is worthy of a pit stop. If only because it's such a crazy, unique experience.
Despite how crazy the history is, you got to admit that the people that own this place now are some of the most brilliant entrepreneurs around. You can learn from this, Ludette. I'm telling you. They have converted this place into a sound bath. What is a sound bath? I don't know. Basically, you bathe yourself in sound, and that's it. And people sit around, pay good money for it. You have to make reservations. You can't even just walk in. You can't even just give them your dollars. They're not even selling fiends. They're selling freaking air. Vibrating air. Now I know we should have gone, but it's too late.
Oh.
Anthony Bourdain went there.
Really?
That's right. He checked it out. A lot of music videos are shot here. So there you go. You lost out. Just because you weren't open-minded enough.